the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your
spirit.
Let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you standing in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God, with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad and my tongue has been exalted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.' My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, He foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, of this we all witness. Exalted at the right hand, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father, and poured him forth, as you see and hear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you invoke this Father Him who judges impartially according to each one's work, conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless and blemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believed in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus. And they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them. But their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sorts of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people. Our chief priests and rulers will hand him over to a sentence of death and crucify him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astonished us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had seen, indeed, a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?' So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, 'The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon.' Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of bread." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's Easter Sunday afternoon, and two disciples are coming down from Jerusalem, which is on a hill, and they're walking towards their home. In Emmaus, 7 miles away, they're walking at a comfortable pace, which is a little more than 2 hours away from the site of the crucifixion to their home. Artists often portray as two male disciples, but I'm almost certain that it's a husband and a wife, a married couple. They invite them into their home when they arrive, of course, as you know. The interesting thing is that Jesus walked with them for a little bit more than 2 hours, and they didn't recognize him. Later, they would recount how their hearts were burning with the message that he shared with them. They would respond to them, now they might take some hold. You know, but because they didn't recognize him, we need to look at some of the other Easter narratives in the Gospels. They have the same punchline. Remember Mary? Mary comes to the tomb. She wants to pray there, visit there, maybe anoint the body. We don't know in this particular gospel, but she comes there and she doesn't find him. She finds the tomb empty. But she sees a man there and she presumes it's the gardener, the man in charge of the place. And she comes to him very politely. She says, "I mean no trouble. I'm not here to cause any harm. Please just tell me where they've taken him so I can go there." She doesn't sees and recognizes that it's Jesus she's talking to. And then last Sunday we saw and heard of Thomas. Jesus came to the disciples in the cenacle in the upper room on Easter Sunday night, but Thomas was not there. And later they told Thomas what they had experienced. And he said, "What do you think I am, stupid? I'm not going to believe it unless I can touch the wounds." And he didn't recognize Jesus. All three of them do recognize Jesus. What caused them to recognize him? Thomas, the wounds of Jesus were exposed. And I would suggest that you and I are very much like Thomas and like Mary, and like the disciples on the road to Emmaus, we often do not recognize the presence of the risen Christ in our midst. So when did Mary recognize him? He said one word, Mary. And we can learn that when we hear our name pronounced with affection and respect, that the risen Christ is among us. And the same with the suffering wounds of others, if only we could reach out and touch the wounds of others, the suffering that people have. Sometimes we can't even imagine what they're going through, but if we could lovingly observe their wounds, we will find the presence of the risen Christ in our midst. And then again, a couple of two disciples on the road to Emmaus, when did they recognize him? In the breaking of bread, and in the Gospel of Luke, and in the Acts of the Apostles written by Luke, whenever you hear the phrase breaking of bread, it means only one thing, it means Eucharist. It doesn't mean peace on the earth, it means Eucharist. We have been deprived of the Eucharist these last 4, 5, 6 weeks because of the virus that has encircled the globe. So we ask the Lord to help us recognize his presence as Mary did, as Thomas did, as the disciples on the road to Emmaus did, even though it doesn't seem as if he's here with us. But he is.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. With complete faith in God, we join together in the presence of the Father to offer these petitions.
That the Church throughout the world may Jesus, our head, grant us reconciliation and unity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
war-torn nations, may there be peace in every place experiencing violence and war. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those saddened or lost from discouragement, may the promises of the risen Lord lift them from their despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in this community who struggle with their faith, may God's word open their hearts and nourish them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our brothers and sisters in Christ who have died, may they rejoice in the presence of our Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the parishioners in St. Heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for medical staff, nurses, doctors, for God's protection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray for the end of this pandemic and for peace and health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we ask that you hear our prayers. We offer them knowing that you will take care of all of our needs. Through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed.
He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before him. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Believe is good, faith is love. People pray for the Lord until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, Thomas, our Pastor, all the clergy and people of the world. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her beloved spouse, Mark, Hedwig, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased in you by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy. May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace.